there was a lot of tension. There was tension because, again, there were certain guys that were here that weren't supposed to be here.
Mm-hmm.
And it caused a lot. It was all, there was already that competitiveness of this guy's taking my job,
mm-hmm.
right? What more, someone that
shouldn't have been there in the first place.
Yeah,
that
first was the contention right. Of, and that's
I mean, just,
if you really had Filipino blood,
yeah.
No
I mean,
problem.
Yeah, yes. no if, problem.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. But just that, what I'm saying, just to, Coach Ryan Gregorio's point was the split in the locker room. Mm-hmm. I think that was between 1999, even more evident in 2001.
Mm-hmm.
I remember Coach Tim Cone trying hard to desperately get us to sit amongst one another in his own locker room.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I think a lot of that, just that, stemmed from that whole issue of whatever you want to call Phil Shams.
That's correct.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
for
correct.
Sure. For
yeah.
sure, definitely.
Yeah. How did you try to?
Well,
I was
in that team that Ali was mentioning,
mm-hmm.
where in the locker room there was a split. So there was their group, and then I was with Camaso, Stephen Padilla, you know, I was EJ File, and we were warming the bench. I could talk with Ali. With John Arrigo, with Rob Duat, yeah, there's no problem. And sometimes, they get intimidated because, again, it's a cultural thing that sometimes people think that just because you don't speak English or good English, that you don't, there's nothing in your head, right? So, and I think a part of the animosity before was caused by jealousy because as a culture of our nation, we tend to give preferential treatment sometimes to foreigners, and we treat them better than our own. And when players, local players, see that there seems to be like a preferential treatment to other, you know, new guys coming in from abroad, and that's where the gap all of a sudden arises.